Coming up on Sports Weekly, the San Gorgonio girls soccer team blanked Ramona in a big non-league match. Plus, basketball highlights of the Arroyo Valley boys at home against Colton and the San Bernardino girls hosting Public Safety Academy. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. Welcome back to Sports Weekly. The San Gorgonio girls soccer team has posted back-to-back 10-0 seasons in the San Andreas League. The Spartans have looked strong in non-league play so far this year, which could signal another undefeated league title in their future. San Gorgonio hosting Ramona from Riverside in non-league play. The Spartans coming off consecutive San Andreas League championships, but we went to halftime of this match scoreless. At the half, head coach Connie Beard trying to rekindle that magic on offense that led them to two consecutive undefeated SAL seasons. See if it works. Second half, San Gorgonio on the attack, but the Ramona keeper comes out and makes a great play on that ball. Then back the other way, the Rams had some opportunities as well, but it remained scoreless until this play. The Spartans would finally break through on the score sheet when Phoebe Amaro circles back around, slips the perfect through ball, and she nets the goal. The left-footed shot there from number six, and San Gorgonio defeats Ramona 1-0, the final score. Now, how about some hoops? Let's take you out to Cardinal City Arena, where San Bernardino hosted Public Safety Academy. The Cardinals would race out to an early lead and never look back in this one. Coming up, it's Melissa Rubino following up the miss and gets the basket. San Bernardino up big, 24-5. The Cardinals really crashing the glass, grabbing offensive boards. June Lynn Parafina gets the putback for San Bernardino. The Cards up by 21. Public Safety Academy still firing away, trying to hang in there. But San Bernardino would have the advantage inside. The Cardinals still going to work on the boards. Not once, not twice, but the third time, the charm for Rubino. Now it's San Bernardino in transition in the second quarter. Charlesha Barnett up ahead to Rubino on the break for two more. Cardinals up by 27. Later in the second quarter, Rosalind Belzer finds a wide open Adriana Williams for the easy layup there. The Cardinals off and running in this one. Tabitha Enriquez up ahead to Belzer for the bucket. The San Bernardino lead balloons to 27 points. San Bernardino would start the game strong, and they would also finish the game strong. Nyjah Emerson, the basket down low as the Cardinals run away with the victory, 91-18. Now to boys' hoops. The Colton Yellow Jackets on the road at Arroyo Valley looking for their first win of the season. Nice bucket early on by the Jackets. Now it's the Hawks with the ball. Justin Lewis dumps it inside to Jordan Tolbert for the basket down low. Arroyo Valley up by 10. Later, check out the great ball movement by Arroyo Valley. It starts with Justin Lewis, then goes all the way around the horn. Back to Lewis for the baseline jumper. Hawks up 21-9. And then it's Lewis working in the post. And then great pass to Elijah Henderson under the rim for the easy bucket. Arroyo Valley up by two touchdowns. The Yellow Jackets looking to hang tough on the road. That bucket helps. But the Hawks were flying around on their home floor. Off the miss, it's Lewis, the follow-up. Arroyo Valley leading by 13 nearing halftime. The Hawks would finish the first half strong. It's Lewis, the short turnaround as Arroyo Valley goes on to win big against Colton. 49-25, the final score. Still to come on Sports Weekly, we've got your girls' water polo highlights as San Bernardino hosted Moreno Valley in league play, plus San Gorgonio and Citrus Valley battle down to the wire. That's coming up on Sports Weekly on IEMG. Well, that'll do it for this episode of Sports Weekly on IEMG. Be sure to check out the IE Media Group YouTube channel to watch this segment and all the past shows of Sports Weekly. And while you're there, you can also subscribe to the channel. I'm Pep Fernandez. I'll see you next time on Sports Weekly on IEMG.